Hello guys, welcome to Mark Shrimp Tanks. Today we are going to be feeding our shrimp some spinach. So today's video is shrimp versus spinach, and I know I've done shrimp versus spinach before, but I actually haven't done it as in a shrimp versus video. Okay, so we're going to pick some spinach here. My wife has planted rows and rows and rows of it here, so yum 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 yum. Let's see, pick some. I need a couple of bits of this for my snails as well, because my snails get this daily. This is very high in calcium. What I'll do about now is I'll put a list of all the vitamins and calcium content that you get from this. More spinach, more! Alright guys, so we are back. We have two different types of spinach here. One is your bog standard spinach, and these ones here are your New Zealand spinach. You can tell the difference because one, the New Zealand spinach is much, much thicker and it's rounder. Okay, so I'm going to keep these for my snails. Okay, and then we're going to cut up these smaller ones just into little pieces. Just sharpen this knife so it's really, really sharp. You see how sharp that is? How good is that? Right, so you guys know, of course, I love this. I love spinach. Let's make sure we have enough for every tank. Okay, and this is probably only second to nettles for me, and the only reason it's second is because you have to buy this and you have to grow it. Nettles is free, so for me that means it goes to the number one spot in my food list. Okay, so we're just going to go around and we are going to add small pieces in some of the tanks that have just a few shrimp that might not all sink. It is no big deal if it doesn't. The shrimp will find it all eventually anyway. What's important, guys, when you do this as well, is to not add too much food to the tank, because you can't pollute your tank if you put too much spinach in, okay? So we want to put in just enough that they will eat this within a few hours. Let's go over here. Forget so much that you guys can't see when I'm doing this. Great video! Alright, so we're putting in enough for everybody here. My shrimp are all doing fantastic, by the way. I can't believe how much of a turnaround things can have, especially when you start understanding how to keep shrimps. Okay, so we're going to go up to the top. Here, is it very dark there? Let's see, what bits will I give them? We'll give them this part. Whoop. Stuck to my finger. And I will have a wee bit left for this. I'll just straighten you up a little bit here. Spin up there. What we're going to do is, we're also, because there's so little left of that type of spinach there, I'm going to add one of Dennis's spinach and moringa pellets as well, just to let you see them on that as well at the same time. Okay, where is it? There you go. I'm also going to show you how I do this with the snails. Let's go over here.
What we're going to do is I'm going to give it to my snails. Let's see if we can get a good picture here. And what I've done with this is I have a plastic peg like this, and I have tied fishing line to it, right? None of this goes in the water, so this metal part will never rust. This is just to hold it like this to the side of the tank. Okay, and that allows me to pull the fishing line up and pull this stainless steel, a little device I've made. Now this is from a tea strainer. I've broken the tea strainer parts off because I use them in other things to do with my shrimp tanks. And all I've done with this, guys, is you can see here is I've bended the ends over, and then I've basically makes a thing that can hold things. You can see that.
So it's a little fastener. All I have to do to get the part is to pull. See? Open. And then we're going to thread in some of these. And this is why I've kept this for the shrimp as well, because for the snails, because spinach, when you even boil it for a little bit of time, it can become very, very soft. Like so, as much as I can on here. I'll put the other bit on the other leg. Like so, and I load this up. Because I have lots and lots of snails in here. I have lots and lots of rams worm snails. When I put this in, I'll show you just how much I have, okay? And then, to close it, I just hold here and pull it like so. Okay, and there you have it. That won't come off. And I just simply lower it into the tank. You see my peg? Here, I probably don't even need to attach this to anything, but I like to just attach it to the side of the tank to keep it neat and tidy. Right, and this will all be gone by tomorrow. And the reason I'm feeding spinach more or less every day is because I still see I have a little bit of shell erosion. Some of these guys, they are repairing themselves, but it's important I give them as much calcium as I can. See all the snails behind there? I have loads and loads of them in here. They're all behind here as well. Okay, so we're going to do the little test like we always do. And I shall be back in 1 second. Welcome back, guys. Let's do a quick overview of the tanks, and we shall talk about the results and what you need to do if you see similar things. Okay, so let's have a look at this one. There's no shrimp on it at all. Now I have probably 10-15 Taiwan bees in here. Let's see if we can find some. It's a lovely girl just there, buried. I think she might be having her babies pretty soon, so she's hiding. Okay, and this, the results like this would be explained by, I fed these guys yesterday. Normally I don't feed them 2 days in a row. So with this, I would remove this. As soon as I'm finished the video, this one will be coming out of here. Let's go into the next tank. Similar results, they're kind of on it. There is a lot of shrimp in here. You'll be able to see them along the glass and stuff. I'm in macro mode, so it won't be able to focus properly. But you get the gist. This one I would too removed from the tank, because you can even see the red one there. It's not actively feeding, it's just sitting there over the food. Let's see these guys. Orange eye blue tigers. Now these ones are, I'm trying to make my this tank my royal blue tiger tank, right? So anyone that you see like here, let me see if you can see my finger, like this one, this little guy is being removed. Same with that guy there, same with that guy. All these ones are being moved over to my other tank over there. It's kind of hard for me to point because we're in marker mode and my finger's huge. So I'm going to have two tanks of blue tigers. One will be royal blue. Some other will have the little rusty effect on them. And my other blue tigers, the ones that have the actual stripes, will be going in another tank. Alright, let's look in here. Where did it go? It's floated away over here. But the similar results to my top tank there. The shrimp are really not on it. They're not actively feeding, so that one will come out of here as well. It's too early to show you this, but you can kind of see the snails kind of gradually working their way up. In an hour or two, this will be absolutely covered in snails. Let's go over to the other tanks. These are the ones I was telling you about that have the stripes. Orange-eyed blue tigers that have stripes. Cherry shrimp. This tank's coming along great. You would have remembered what this looked like a few weeks ago. There would have been hardly any shrimp showing. One of my favourites here, and it's just going into focus, this one has a, pardon my swearing, a shit ton of shrimp in here. They're everywhere, on the filters. The lot. I have a little bonus clip for you guys as well, that you will probably see on the end of this section. Focus, please. Aren't they wonderful? I've actually started to selectively breed this tank again. I let it go for so long and a lot of the shrimp were really, really bad. But as you can see, I've been selectively breeding them for probably about the last month. A lot of the worst looking ones have been removed. And the good thing, guys, about having lots of different shrimp from Michelin's is I still get Taiwan bees from these guys, okay? If I see it, I'm going to quickly show you it. If I don't see it, I've already recorded this little Missouri bolt. Let's see, can I get in here? If it focuses, you will see it. If it doesn't, you will see it at the end of the video, okay? I will add it on. Alright, now on to, this was the spinach I put in, this was the fresh stuff, but what is very, very, very interesting is I noticed with the Dennis's stuff that they were super ravenous over Dennis's stuff compared to the stuff of the garden. You can clearly see the difference. You will see it in the video as well. And the first clip you will see will be the organic stuff, and this is Dennis's stuff. I don't know, I can see on his one it says it has a moringa in it. This is not an ad, by the way, because you can't buy this stuff. So this is not an ad or an endorsement. You can't get the stuff yet. So it's just to show you the effects. I've been hard culling these guys as well. I've been taking out as much of the bad ones as I can. I've been removing all the goldens. They've been going into their own golden tank. All the crystal blacks have been going into the crystal black tank. I have been seeing again more Taiwan bees. If I see one before I go, I will show you them. Red ones, pandas, etc. But that is today's video. Little golden there. That is today's video, guys. If you enjoyed it, please give me a big, big thumbs up. I love you loads. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask me in the comment section below, and I'll catch you in the next one. Happy shrimp keeping.